July the 30th, today's wisdom. Two things have I required of thee. Two things have I required of thee. Deny me them not before I die. Proverbs 30:7. In this verse, the wise gives to his audience a lesson on prayer. Prayer by example. Specific, short, precise, based on a firm faith. Is prayer part of our values? How do we evaluate ourselves, our prayer life? Prayer is the act of speaking, communing with God. It's a dialogue, not a monologue. The wise prays, saying, I. We observe a personal pronoun, which shows the importance of the personal prayer. It's so important for a couple, a family, or a community to pray together. But if each member doesn't have a true prayer life as an individual, then this prayer time with others will lack a foundation, further an impact. In most cases, the more God grants us responsibilities, the less we pray, while it should be the contrary. It is so easy to spend time going up and down, missing out the essential. The best way to get agitated is rushing to do things without spending some time in prayer. The quality and quantity of time put aside every day in prayer is equivalent to the value granted to God in prayer. If I believe God is a good and personal God, that He desires the best for me and that He wants to commune with me, then it will be possible for me to value prayer and to discipline myself to practice it every single day given to me by God. Prayer is an act of faith. Prayer is the evidence of faith. The lack of prayer is a symptom of a spiritual cooling, discouragement, and unbelief. Without faith, it is impossible to have a lively, intentional, perseverant, and victorious prayer life. If faith is the engine of prayer, then prayer is the fuel of faith. What matters for God first is not prayer, but the one who prays. My prayer life would not go beyond my meditation's life of the Word of God. The intensity and fervor of our prayer will depend on the quantity of the Word of God engraved in the tablet of our heart. The more we grow in maturity, the more prayer changes its focus, moving from us towards God. Jesus says, "But thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet, and when thou hast shut thy door, pray to thy Father which is in secret, and thy Father which seeth in secret shall reward thee openly." Matthew 6:6. 1. We observe in this recommendation of Jesus to his disciples a particular emphasis on the personal and secret dimension of prayer. Why that? 2. It is so because God desires first to have a personal relationship with each of his children. Truth. God desires to have an intimate and personal relationship with each of his children. Application. To value and desire prayer, to decide and find some time to pray, to discipline ourselves to pray regularly and consistently for the glory of God. Recommendation. But when you pray, use not vain repetitions, as the heathen do, for they think that they shall be heard for their much speaking. Matthew 6:7. Let's pray together. Lord Jesus, teach me to pray. Luke 11:1. Today's reading. Psalm 146-50, Ezekiel 13-15, Proverbs 30, you are blessed.